how to remove and then install a square taper or Octalink bottom bracket. You will need an ISIS Octalink bottom bracket tool, or cartridge bottom bracket tool if you like, along with a half inch drive. This particular model from Bikehand is designed to slot over an 8mm Allen wrench, which you'll also need. Or you can grab one from your Allen key set, which is a must for every bike owner. A roll of shop towels will also come in handy. A torque wrench such as this one is recommended. You solve the problem of correct torque settings later, and it also has the half inch drive that you will need for the bottom bracket tool. Firstly, we'll loosen, then remove the non-drive side lock ring. The challenge is loosening off the drive side, which is actually the cartridge body of the bottom bracket as a whole. You'll probably have to use some leverage. Here I'll use a seat post to give me some more length and a good measure of extra leverage to break the unit free of the BB shell. If you don't have an old seat post handy, any narrow diameter pipe will do. A torque wrench with the torque setting turned up to 70 Newton meters or so will give me all the leverage I need in this case. The combined leverage of the longer handle and the high torque would be enough to break even the toughest BB free of the shell. Using a large wrench like this one is by far the easiest way. All that remains now is to continue to turn the bottom bracket cartridge and remove it from the BB shell. Before installing the bottom bracket, it's a good idea to tap the BB shell to ensure the threads are in perfect condition. This is especially important if you are installing the BB into a new bike. I'll carefully rotate the cyclist tapping and facing tools tapping bits into the bottom bracket shell to make sure they are fitted exactly to the threads. They don't need to go in far, just enough so they are seated in the threads. Once the bits are properly seated, they will turn smoothly. Any resistance after this stage, however, means the threads need to be cut. Applying cutting oil assists in preserving the tool's cutting edges, plus it assists turning a bit in the shell, especially when a good deal of cutting needs to be done. There's already quite a lot of resistance in the non-drive side, which means that these threads will need cutting their whole length. That's reached the limit, so now for the other side. The drive side is easier, so the bit turns smoothly into the shell with little resistance. That's the limit with that one. And Harry looks happy with the result, so I have the green light for removing the tool. Now to clean out the aluminium detritus prior to applying the grease. And I'll give the tapping bits a clean while I'm at it. Grab a pair of nitrile gloves for handling the grease. I'll firstly give the bottom bracket shell a coating. Whether you are installing a new BB cartridge or reinstalling the old one, a good coat of grease is essential. Wipe off the grease from the old one and apply a fresh coat. Fitting the bottom bracket threads exactly to the BB shell threads is crucially important. It is very easy to think you have got it right, begin turning, then come up against resistance. It's highly likely that you will have cross-threaded the cartridge into the shell, and by continuing to force it, you will ruin the threads, which will mean they will have to be recut. It's often necessary to just rotate the cartridge in the opposite direction, whereupon it will click into the right groove, allowing you to smoothly wind it all the way in. Once the BB shell and the BB cartridge are flush, the torque needs to be adjusted to tolerance once the non-drive side lock ring is greased and installed. Time to use the tool to finish the job. I'll tighten it to the upper limit of the range, which is from around 35 Newton meters to 42. That's set at 42, so I'll lock it down with the nut. The leverage provided by this torque wrench makes a higher torque possible with relative ease. With a shorter wrench, you'd find 38 newtons would be enough. Now for the non-drive side. Where the lock ring is plastic, there's no need for a torque wrench. Getting it snugly tight will be fine. We hope you found this video useful, and please subscribe, give a thumbs up or thumbs down, and hit that bell notification so you'll know when our next video drops. Thanks for watching.